turn our attention to two overseas stories right now with Dr. Alan Mendoza. He's founder and executive director at the Henry Jackson Society. Good morning to you, Alan.
Good morning,
Good
Julia.
Morning to you. Let's talk first of all about something we've seen on our screens in the last few days, and this is the armored tanks rolling into cities in Myanmar as tensions are rising again after the trial of Aung San Suu Kyi beginning at, ahead of schedule and without the knowledge or presence of her lawyer. What a surprise, under a military junta in Myanmar. We've seen incredibly brave protests, day after day after day on the streets. I mean, with huge numbers of thousands of people peacefully protesting, facing now rubber bullets, water cannon, and now these armored tanks. Is there really any hope that this this military rule will be overcome, that the democratically elected government can be put back into place, or indeed that anyone in the West is going to try and help?
Well, the latter question is the easiest one to answer, that which is that although Western countries can provide moral support in this case, short of reapplying sanctions, which I think we should do, it's very difficult to obviously directly do more than that in the country, because you've got the country's chief paymaster, China, basically supporting the move. So that's problem number one. However, what we can certainly do is provide moral support for the protesters who have shown, as you said, tremendous fortitude getting out there, risking their lives to try and restore a democracy that they have only recently, had reintroduced in the first place. And I think it's very heartening to see civil society in Myanmar rising up and saying, not in our name, thank you very much. You get back to your barracks and we're going to try and force you back to your barracks through a campaign of civil disobedience. Yeah. Now, whether it'll work or not, that depends very much on the resolution of the media, of the military, and how they think they're going to react to this. Are they ultimately prepared to kill their citizen? This is what any conflict of this kind always comes down to. So far, they haven't been, but that may change. And of course, we don't want to see any bloodshed, but that's the essential point of working out whether this is going to succeed or not.
Yeah, indeed. Well, let's come a little bit closer to home, but not far, in the Middle East, Dubai. And extraordinary, the footage, it's been all over the media. It's on the front page of a lot of the papers today. And this is the Dubai ruler's daughter. He's Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid Al Maktoum. We've seen pictures of him with the Queen. He's one of the most richest men in the world. And his daughter, Princess Latifa, videos emerged that she's recorded from where she is being held hostage. She hasn't been seen now for many, many months. She recorded these videos a very long time ago, got them out via friends to journalists, saying basically giving her first-hand account of when she was in 2018, tried to flee Dubai, managed to make her escape, sailed on a yacht to the Indian coast, just an international waters team of commandos sent by her father, basically taking her by force and returning her to Dubai under house arrest. She has spoken out. Do you think that any action will happen as a result of this, other than Dominic Raab, the foreign secretary, sort of wagging his finger and saying that the United Nations needs to do something?
The short answer is no. And I think, the foreign secretary this morning was talking about this in a very embarrassed light. I mean, he's an ally of the UK at the end of the day, which is acting in what can be described as a feudal manner. Yeah. We wouldn't tolerate it in other circumstances, and it seems quite extraordinary that we're prepared to just, sit back and say, oh, we'll let the UN do it. I mean, seriously, Julia, when was the last time the UN did anything like this effectively and was able to call any despot out? You only have to look at the UN Human Rights Council to look at some of the worst malefactors of human rights are on it. If you think the human rights, apparatus in the UN is going to sort this out, you're having a laugh.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, the Foreign Secretary Dominic Raab has said this morning, people want to see the missing Dubai princess and see that she is alive and well. And the reason why actually the journalists that she's been in contact with via friends, why they showed these videos now is because they are concerned for her safety and that she has just basically disappeared. They've had no contact for many, many months now. And there's got to be a concern that this is what happens to an awful lot of women in Dubai and other countries which operate under a medieval system, which seems to think that women are effectively the property of either their fathers or their husbands.
Yeah, it's a crazy situation. I think there's a simple message sent to Dubai's ruler, which is, look, Daddy, your daughter doesn't love you anymore, and you've behaved badly, and you don't imprison her as a result. You try and work it out, and if you can't work it out, you let her go, and you hope you can reconcile sometime later. That is a normative relationship. It's a pretty simple conversation to have, it's extraordinary that we in today's world we're seeing this. But I want to make a broader point. Yep. Look carefully, Julia, at the number of say British citizens who are held hostage in other countries. Look at Iran, for example. Yeah. We've got people there. What have we done to punish countries that have taken our own hostages, our own citizens hostage, absolutely nothing.
Yeah.
So the idea we're going to punish another country for taking one of its citizens hostage is laughable. We can't even look after our own citizens.
And we didn't even take any action when another one of the members of that Dubai royal family was kidnapped off the streets of Cambridge in our own country. Extraordinary. Thank you very much, Dr. Alan Mendoza from the Henry Jackson Society.